Hello and welcome to today's phonics lesson. We're going to be learning another phase 3 trigraph today. To take part in our learning today, you will need a piece of lined paper and a pencil. Pause the video and collect the resources you need and then click play once you're ready. Shall we begin? We're going to start by singing an alphabet song, just as we always do, to practice our letter names. The song we're going to sing today is to the tune of Wheels on the Bus. Can you sing along with me? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Look, I have circled 4 letters. Can you tell me the letter names? Starting from the bottom this time, going up to the top. At the bottom we have Y, then T, K, and at the top, B. Let's recap our common exception words. These are words that do have some phonic clues, but do you remember they have some tricky bits as well? When I show you the words, see if you can read it to me straight away, as clearly and quickly as you can. If you need more thinking time, just pause the video on a word and then click play once you're ready. Can you recall all of your sounds to me? I'm going to show you all of your phase 3 and phase 2 graphemes. And what I would like you to do is tell me the phoneme, the sound that they make. You just need to tell me once, and I'd be really impressed if you could do your actions as well. Great recall. Wow, we know so many sounds now, don't we? We're going to take a look at our new grapheme in a moment and see which phoneme it makes. But first, let's learn another new common exception word. This is the common exception word, they. My turn. They. Your turn. My turn. They. Your turn. Let's see if we can use any phonic clues to help us with this word. We're going to do that by sounding it out and blending it together. Now, I have noticed a digraph at the beginning of this word. Z-a-y, they. Does that sound like the word they? What is the tricky part? The e and y is making an a sound in they, but I can hear the phoneme for the digraph t and h, th, at the start. We need to remember that this is the word they. Let's see which phase 3 trigraph we're going to learn today. It is the trigraph air. We can pretend that our hands are a hot air balloon reaching up to the sky as we say air. Can you think of any words that have the phoneme air in them? Pause the video and think of some words, and then click play. Which air words did you think of? I thought of the word staircase. Have you got a staircase in your house? Or perhaps you've walked up one before? And the word fairground. Have you ever seen a fairground? We're going to practice forming this trigraph now. Each letter belongs to a different letter family. Do you know which letter families they belong to? The A goes around in a curve. So it must be a curly caterpillar letter. We're going to practice forming it in the air. Can you put your finger on the green dot? Let's go around, up, down and flick. Can we do that one more time? Start on the green dot. Around, up, down and flick. Now it's time to write the I. I belongs to the ladder letter family. Can you see it goes down in a line? Let's practice forming it in the air. Start on the green dots. Down, flick and dots at the top. And one more time. Ready? Down, flick and dot at the top. Which letter family does R belong to? It's a one-armed robot letter. Can you help me to practice forming it in the air? Put your finger on the green dots. Down, up and over. One more time. Down, up and over. We're going to practice writing it on our paper now. Make sure you've got a good writing position, with your chair tucked in, 2 feet on the floor, and one hand resting on your piece of paper to keep it nice and still. With your other hand, pick up your pencil and put it in between two lines. Can you follow with me? Around, up, down, and flick. Did you get that A sitting on the line? Let's do the I. Down, flick. And dots at the top. Is that the same height as the A? Let's do the R the same height again. Down, up and over. Are all three of your letters sitting on the line? And are they all the same height? Pause the video and practice forming this trigraph. Then click play once you're ready. It's time for us to read some words with the air trigraph. I have added sound buttons to help us to spot the trigraph and the digraphs in the words. Let's sound and blend the first one. Ooh, air, lair. Do you know what a lair is? It's like a den or a hideout. The air trigraph is at the end of our next word as well. Let's sound and blend it together. Air, fair. Excellent blending. And the last one. Air, ship. Airship. Look, that is a picture of an airship. And an airship is a kind of aeroplane which has a large bag of air around it, keeping it up in the sky. We have three air words to write. At the top, they are playing tug of war. There are three people on one team and only one on the other. That is very unfair. Can you write the word unfair? Stretch it out first. Unfair. Unfair. And put it on your phoneme fingers. Unfair. Unfair. Write it down. Remember, for the air trigraph, you need an A, an I, and an R. The next word is the word chair. Let's stretch out the word chair. Ch-air, chair. And using your phoneme fingers, ch-air, chair. This word has a digraph and a trigraph. Can you write it down? You might underline your digraph and your trigraph to show me that you know where they are and that they represent just one phoneme. I wonder if you can see what that is in the final picture, and I wonder if you have ever been to one before. It's an airport. Where is the phoneme air in airport? It is at the beginning. Let's stretch out this word. Airport. Airport. And put it on your phoneme fingers. Airport. Airport. Can you write it down? I wonder if you have spotted the digraph that is in this word as well. You could show me what trigraphs and digraphs you've spotted by adding your sound buttons. We're going to check our spellings now. If you're still writing this word, then just click pause and click play when you're ready to see the spellings. It is time for you to tick or fix each spelling. I wonder if you have made any marvellous mistakes that you can learn from today. It's really good to exercise and stretch our brains in that way. It is time for us to apply our learning to reading a sentence. With your finger, can you circle all of the common exception words? Using your finger, can you underline the four trigraphs in this sentence? Did you find them all? Pause this video and read the sentence three times to practice your fluency, and then click play once you've done so. Can you read this sentence with me? My fair hair was in a pair of hairbands. Look, her fair hair is in a pair of hairbands. Well done for all of the reading and writing we have done in our phonics today. We've learnt another new trigraph now, haven't we? And a new common exception word. Thank you, everyone.